Football,
basketball, golf. Some student athletes try to play a sport in every single season. But that can take a toll on a young athlete's body.
March is National Athletic Training Month, so we thought we'd ask the experts how to help give yourself and your body a break. The Valley Today's Christy Larson joins us live from Sanford Power with more this morning. Good morning, Christy.
Yes, good morning, Kyle and Lisa. That's right. You know, stretching is one important thing no matter what type of an athlete you are. But we're also joined by Al Kraft, and you have much more important things for those high schoolers who are sometimes in one, two, three sports at a time.
Yes, this time of year we have several athletes that might be transitioning from like basketball or to track, and so not only are they going from one sport to another, but they're also sometimes in two sports at the same time. So we really have to watch to make sure they get enough rest and recovery, get good nutrition, and then also just avoid overtraining.
And I know you said nutrition is a huge part of it, because after you do an intense workout like some of those high schoolers do, you really want to make sure that they're putting a lot of those carbs and the protein back in their body.
Sure. Most athletes have about a two-hour window after a practice or a training session, and you want to get some type of carbohydrate, fluid, and protein back in your system. So a really simple one is just get some skim milk in your system. It has the right ratio of carbohydrate and protein. They're getting some fluid back in their system too.
And I know you said another important thing too is for parents even to recognize what their athletes are doing and when they're starting to kind of get pushed a little too far over the edge.
Sure. As a parent and as an athletic trainer, you want to be aware of the signs and symptoms of overtraining. So if an athlete shows reduced performance, or if they're irritable, or if they're having aches and pains that may lead to overuse injuries, or if they have just low motivation, that's where the parent needs to recognize that, or even more so the athletic trainer step in and communicate that to the coach so they can modify their training.
And I know another big thing also is to make sure that you're admitting that too. And you know, as an athlete, you need to be honest with your athletic trainers so that they can help you the most. And Kyle and Lisa, I did want to show you guys, they showed me a stretch. And this is really good for someone who sits at a computer all day, which is a lot of us out there. I'm just going to kind of do it. You tuck your arms, point your elbows, and use a foam roller. It's really simple.
I actually bought one of those foam rollers.
She's been practicing.
Oh, she's been practicing. Yeah. she's like the happiest.
That's a good idea, though. I love that. You know, there's some of those times when you get done with an 8-hour shift at work.
Oh, and you feel it.
You just kind of got that little kink in your neck or your back.
You're doing shoulders and back, huh?
Yeah. You don't even have to be a, you know, elite athlete to benefit from something like this. Christy Larson reporting live from Sanford's Power. Thank you, Christy.